Hello, my dear students and friends. Welcome to my session on SolidWorks in 21 days. We are on day 15. In today's session, we will see about some basic assemblies like knuckle joint, epicyclic gear, pantograph, Peaucellier mechanism, and so on. Okay. We'll go to the session straight away. I may not be giving you the part files because you try by yourself. Let me give the enough detail about how you can do it. So this is the assembly. I'll be showing only the assembly files of all the things. So this is the knuckle joint assembly. I think we could say fork end, because it is a U shape, you know. Then this is I end, so both will be swinging, okay, which is a fixed one. The pin is a fixed member. About this one, all the other things will rotate, so this cannot be rotated. This can move this way. This is the lock pin, right? You will see all these things one by one. You see, now it is I have given a slight taper. After inserting a bush, we'll do the motion analysis, collision detection between these components. This one, and this one. Stop at collision. Where is it? Stop at collision, resume drag. Now I am inserting. Now you see, after that, I am moving the mouse, but it hits. This pin hits this bush. So it cannot move further. So like that, you can check all these things, okay? In the same way, swinging these two, actually, theoretically, it can swing. Actually, it should not swing 360 degree. It should hit somewhere here, okay? But we have some minimal assembly constraints or mating constraints. So with that only, we assembled it, okay? So perfect thing, we can see it in this collision detection. These components, this one I end and the fork end, resume drag. Now let me move. Now I think if these two portions meet, and now it hits. Now let me see this way. I'm moving. Now it hits. It started hitting. I end started hitting the fork end. Okay. So this is how you can see all the motion analysis, actually all the motion analysis also. And in one of the sessions, I already showed you how to record these sequences. This is the screen recorder. Now if you see that, right click in the tab somewhere there, yes, for screen capture. Okay, you can switch on or you can switch off. Now it is switched off just before. Now let me switch on. You can capture the image, but instead of this one, you can take the print screen. Using the print screen button, you can capture the image. Okay, let me keep somewhere here. So this is the video, start video. So knuckle joint assembly AVI. So 1, 2, 3 AVI file. It will be stored only in AVI file. I already told you about how to create a video, how to make the video from your assembly or from your SolidWorks. I am telling you once again, right? Now it started recording 123.avi file. So this one, everything is done. Now this will be, this I am doing it, but it should not rotate 360 degree. What I can do is, let me introduce assembly constraints also. Move. Collision detection, these components, this and this, resume drag, it hits, it won't move further. Okay, let me stop the video. Okay, now if you go to my folder, 123 AVI file created, let me double click. I think it's supposed to play. This application will not play, so right click, open with Windows Media Player or VLC Player. this will play the video. You are seeing, I think you are getting only the screen only, the active window only, not the menus and all. You are not able to see the menu now. Okay, so that will be still better in one angle. Okay, so that is sufficient for this one. Okay, so create some part. Now let me show you the one part how I made it. Let me close fork end. Now if you, with the help of the rollback button, so first I created a fork end, then various operations I performed. Okay, so slowly I added more and more features to make this particular part. So I already told you, a feature has one or more sketches, a part has many features. So it is a part has these many features, right? So using the rollback button, you can see how one has done the part in stages. Okay, so that is about the knuckle joint. Then we see about the epicyclic gear. But when it comes to epicyclic gear, some information you should know. Let me tell you. There are three different gears and one arm. One is called sun gear. Let me type as sun only. Okay. Planetary gear, ring gear, and arm. Arm is not a gear. This arm houses the three or four or five planetary gears, right? So these are the particulars when it comes to epicyclic gear. Now let me open the epicyclic gear. There are two assemblies I made with this. You see, arm is one part, pinion gear, that is called the planetary gear, ring gear, sun gear. So this is one file. Okay, so you are not seeing the, I didn't show the holes, the gear teeth you can't see. Actually this is called the ring gear have internal gear teeth. This is the pinion gears or planetary gear. Three planetary gears are there. These three planetary gears are housed in this arm. This arm is not a gear, and this is the sun gear. The sun gear has a number of teeth there. Okay, but for rotation, to see the rotation only, I put small holes. A hole in the sun gear, this is a hole in the planetary gear, this is a hole in the ring gear. So in this particular case, you see that assembly of arm locked. Where is the arm? This is the arm. This is locked. I cannot. Oh, it's a transparent one. That is why. Yeah. Since I showed transparency, okay. Let me put. Now you see. Now I cannot move. I cannot move the arm. So I maintain some transparency as far as arm is concerned, because since I give some transparency, then only you are able to see the planetary gears or pinion gears. Okay, so in the other thing, let me open parallelly the ring gear. It same thing but different assemblies. Here the ring is locked. I cannot move this one. Okay, let me show it the rear view. This is rear view of arm locked. this will not move. A arm has this hole. You see, this arm has this hole. This hole will not move because arm is locked. Now let me rotate the sun gear. If I rotate sun gear clockwise, this will turn in anti-clockwise. These two are internal inverting. This again in turn will turn in anti-clockwise only. Now you see clockwise. This is anti-clockwise. If this is anti-clockwise, this is still anti-clockwise. The arm hole is not rotating. You see that? This is the arm hole because since the arm is locked, okay, ring gear is working. If ring gear is locked, arm will rotate. This epicyclic gear train is used in many places, in many machines, especially in tractors. Tractor rear wheel is a big wheel, you know. So, but you need a very high level of gear reduction. Whenever you need a certain high level of gear reduction, you have to then at the same time, if the space is so compact, if you are not having any space, enough space, then you have to necessarily go in for the epicyclic gear train. If there is a space, if the space is a constraint, and if you want a more gear ratio, then you have to go for epicyclic gear train only. Okay, so that is it. Now the arm hole is not rotating, ring is rotating. Now we'll go to the rim locked assembly. Okay, you see this is the hole in arm, this is the hole in ring. Now let me rotate the sun. The pinions are rotating, arm is also, now arm is rotating, ring is not rotating because the ring is locked. So like this, by releasing one, arresting other, you will have different gear ratios in epicyclic gear gear train. That is the specialty about the epicyclic gear train. So again, I repeat, as far as epicyclic gear train is concerned, sun gear, planetary gear, or pinion gear, ring gear. Planetary gear generally three or more will be there. Then arm is not a gear, it is an arm holding the planetary gears or the pinion gears, pinions. Shall I close this one? Okay. Then we see pantograph. This pantograph mechanism is used in copy turning lathe. Suppose if we miss our keys, I think there are shops to make the duplicate keys, you know. So if you give a key, they'll give you the duplicate. Similar to that, they'll make one. Okay, they copy the the pantograph principle. I could say that is a copy turning lathe or copy turning machine that uses the pantograph mechanism. This pantograph mechanism is the key, the important for making the keychain keys used in locks, right? So they take the profile from the master base. Then the other end, it gets the machining is being carried out in the workpiece for getting a duplicate key, right? We'll open that one. Pantograph. Yeah, this is a pantograph. It is nothing but, you see, if this length, let me measure it. If this length is say 400, then this should be 200. This will be 200 if I suppose. Okay, so that means 1:2 ratio is maintained. Again, the logic is these two, this hole and this hole are important. Okay, so if I move this one, say 100 mm, let it be, this hole would have moved in XY direction together in 50 mm because it is 1:2 ratio. okay, or vice versa. If it has moved 60 mm, this would have moved 30 mm only. So everything as per the both in x direction as well as in y direction. Okay, so this is y direction, this is x direction, this is x, this is y. So on 1:2 ratio this will move. So this is the logic behind this one. So this coordinate, if you want, you can note down now. This arm length is note down. So this is 400. You please note down. And if that is the 400, then this distance 400 by 2, 200. If this is 200, this is also 200. And this is 150, means this should also be 150. This should 150, and this should also be 150. That is, in this direction 200 100 is the ratio. This side 150 300, this side 200 400, this side 150 300. Again 1:3 is maintained. Okay, like that you design 1 2 3 4 different bars, only for one is for locking. So it is also a 4 bar mechanism. 5 different bars you make it, 5 different parts. Okay, here you can see that 5 parts: part 1, part 2, part 3, part 4, part 5, right? In that, part 1 is fixed one, you should not move, then only you will get the assembly functionality. Okay, so using that ratio you can do it on your own. Okay, let me close this one. So the other one, Peaucellier mechanism, it is called straight line mechanism. It is called straight line mechanism. Okay, I'll show you that. Peaucellier mechanism assembly. See, actually there are 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 bars are there, but the part 1 4 times it occurs, because then this part 2 occasions, part 4 and part 3. Okay, actually part wise there are only 4 parts. This is a fixed part. These two are one and the same, but I inserted twice here. These four are one and the same, but inserted 4 times here. This is another one. So strictly speaking, there are four arms. In assembly point of view, it has 8 bars. Okay, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Now I have drawn a line also here. Let me put the top view now. Now you see about this one, I am about to tilt. Now you see this particular whole point, it follows straight line, that it is sliding on that straight line only. That is why it is called straight line mechanism. Even about this one, I am tilting. You look at this one alone, okay, that follows that straight line only, no deviation. Now about this, I am tilting, it follows straight line only. About this, I am tilting, it follows the straight line. About this, I am tilting, straight line, again straight line, again straight line. That is why the Peaucellier mechanism is called the straight line mechanism. In many machines they use this motion. Actually suppose say if you want a linear motion at this particular point, fix a motor here, you will get a thing. See, one thing is important in any machine design. The simplest way of thing is fixing a rotary motor, because any electrical motor, it is of rotary in type, rotational motion only you get. But that rotation somehow using some mechanical mechanism, you have to get either oscillatory, translatory, linear, reciprocatory, sliding, any motion you should get. But the starting is origin, circular motion, rotational motion. Rotational motion should be, you are able to convert that rotational motion into this one, into any type of motion. That means you can just put a motor, very simple. Okay, now let me show you. You please note down the values. This arm distance you note down 120 mm, this arm distance 280, so this is 120, this is 280, this is 280, this is also 120, it seems. Yes, 120. So these two arms 120, these two arms 280, and these four arms are equal in length, that is 80. So there are only 8 members, but only there are three values: 80, 120, 280. Make a note of it. Okay, so with this, by just seeing the video, you try by yourself. Okay, you see, at least you can get this kind of information from the internet or through this video. At least I am here for you to teach you and to inform you about the Peaucellier mechanism. But there is no one for me. I learned everything on my own. So that means I would have spent a lot of hours getting some inputs for this particular mechanism, right? So I don't want to type it here also, right? You try again. So four members, 80, 1 and 2, this is 120, 1 and 2, these are 280. So then it will follow the straight line only. It will follow the straight line only. Okay. So what else? Peaucellier mechanism is over. Let me show you one more thing, maybe. A robotic arm. A simple one only. Not a difficult thing. Now let me see it in this view or in the other view. Now you see the parallelism is maintained. This angle is not altered by tilting this one, but actually it is not so. Now it is it can be tilted this way, and this can move this way, and it will have rotation also. So this is how the robotic arms are working now, right? So this is not that much because even practically this is not correct, but you can make assemblies like this in SolidWorks. So that is what I want to emphasize now, right? So in today's session, you saw about knuckle joint, epicyclic gear train, arm is locked, or the ring gear is locked. So two different gear ratios and two different types of motion. You got it, pantograph for copy turning lathe, Peaucellier mechanism, that is nothing but the straight line mechanism. You have seen all this. Okay, so that's it for today. So kindly subscribe my channel if you like it, and pass on this information to your colleagues and students, student friends, so then they'll also gain some knowledge and input through my sessions actually. Thank you.